Hey, what's up? How's it going, everybody? Welcome to the YouTube channel of Petroleum from Scratch. I'm Jayesh Char, and this is Petroleum Data Analytics and Machine Learning Playlist. So in our last video, we discussed about random number generation that doesn't follow any data distribution. So in this video, we are going to discuss how to generate certain random numbers or an array of random numbers that are following certain random data distributions. In statistics, there are certain kinds of distributions like normal distribution, uniform distribution, binomial distributions, and Poisson distribution. So here in this video, we are going to discuss some distributions and how to generate random numbers that are going to follow those distributions. Again, the video about data distribution, we will discuss in briefly. In depth, we will discuss in our coming videos in our statistic playlist. We will discuss thoroughly through these data distributions. So don't worry if you don't get anything, but you will get a rough idea that how our data distributions work. So our main thing is to know how to generate random numbers that are going to follow those random distribution. So first of all, what is a random distribution? Random distribution is nothing but a set of random numbers that follows a certain probability density function. For example, in our last video, we discussed about choice method for choosing the numbers and also providing the probability of each number. In a similar way, there are certain fixed distributions that follows fixed distribution that follows fixed probability. For example, in normal distributions, the data, the mean of the data is going to have highest probability, means that mean will repeat a number of times. So highest frequently repeated number in a normal distribution is a mean. So you can say the mean will be more in your normal distribution. We will see the graph how that's look, but that is a rough idea. For one more example is uniform distribution. What happens in a uniform distribution, like you have a set of numbers and the probability of each number repeating is equal. So that's why its name is uniform distribution, meaning uniform probability of each of the number. So, okay, we will start our video from here. So first of all, as you know, our first step will be importing the important libraries. In this video, we are also going to visualize the distribution. That's why I'm importing Matplotlib as well as Seaborn. That will be used for visualizing distributions by various methods, various plots, distribution plots or histograms we will use. So yeah, we will start our video once a minute. Yeah. So first of all, we will import the libraries. We have imported NumPy as np, matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Matplotlib is nothing but a MATLAB plotting library and a Seaborn. Seaborn is also a visualization library. So we will use these libraries for visualization. That's why I'm importing them. So here I have imported them. So as you know, as I said that in our previous video, we discussed about choice. And in choice, we used to give a specific probability for each value. So I will give you an example how that is done. Let us create an array name x that is going to have the values 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And probability of each value is given, as you can say, 0.05 is for 3, 0.1 for 4 in this way. So here you can see the highest value is going to be our 6, our mean, our median value is going to be have a highest number of probability to come. And I'm creating a array of 100 shape. So let us say I've created this x, and when I'm going to see my x here, you can see, and you can also see that the maximum number of time of repetition number is 6. And if I'm going to plot the histogram for this array, then you can also be able to visualize this. Okay, I have written the capital X. Here you can see that. Okay, one more thing. Histogram is nothing. Histogram will give you how many times a number is repeating for a given array or a list or something. For example, I have written plot.hist and I have given x as input. So it is going to represent different values present in x, and on the y-axis, it will give me the total number of values that it is coming. So for example, here you can see, once a minute, let me adjust the bean size as 7. So that it will be a continuous histogram. So here you can see the maximum occurring value in this array is 6. Here you can see 6 is present in between. And by side, as we go sideways, the probability of coming the other values side by the 6 is decreasing. So you can see that 6 is our mode here. Mode is nothing but the value that is repeated most number of times in a given array or list. and 6 is also a median. If you see 3, 4, 5, and 7, 8, 9. So 6 is present in median also. And if you calculate the mean of this distribution, that will also be a 6. So it is kind of following a normal distribution, we can say. But yeah, we will discuss also in the next thing that how a normal distribution comes. But before that, moving on forward, I will want to discuss some things about these graphs that we are going to use. So this is a histogram graph, histogram on which x-axis is representing our values that are present in the array, and y-axis is representing the value count, that how many times, for example, total size was 100. So from 100 values, 25 values are of my 6. 6 is coming 25 times. In a similar way, 5 is coming 20 times. So you get an idea that y-axis will give me a count of values that is coming. And the other important graph is this plot, distribution plot, that is of Seaborn. So in distribution plot, what happens that everything remains same. Here you can see everything remains same. Count is present on the y-axis. On the x-axis, the numbers are present. But here I have enabled a kernel density function also. So this that will do nothing but smoothen our histogram so that we can get a rough idea that, okay, it will look like this way only. So I have set in my KD as true so that I get a kernel density estimation graph also. So this is this plot. And one other plot that is important is dist plot, that is sns.dist. And this plot is nothing but our distribution plot. And when I'm going to give x, here you can see it is kind of similar to this graph, but on the y-axis you will see that here instead of count, it is density, kernel density function that is coming. It is density, basically probability density. So what probability density is, it is nothing but here you can see there are total number of cases, total number of values present in my x array was 100. Out of that 100, 25 values are corresponding to 6, or you can say 5.5 to 6.5, because bin size is adjusted in that way. So whenever we are going to divide this y-axis with the total number of counts that is present in my array, that will give me a probability density function. For now, just remember this thing only. In future, in statistics playlist, we will discuss it in detail. So on the y-axis, there is nothing but a probability density function. Basically, more the value of probability density function means that value corresponding to the x-axis is going to be repeated more time. For example, here you can see that 8 is kind of lying in this area in probability density function, having a value of 0.15, and 6 is kind of having a 0.25. So again, if you are going to check here, we have divided this y-axis by 100. So whenever 25 is divided by 100, it will be coming to 0.25, corresponding to 6. So it is coming 6. Here in a similar way. So yeah, that is the case. Just kind of give a rough estimate, probability density function kinds of give us rough estimation that, okay, this value is going to be repeated more number of times than the any other value. So now comes distribution. So first, the most important distribution in our life, or you can say in the world, is normal distribution. So what happens in normal distribution, that the above example is kind of an example of normal distribution. The most occurring point is our median. Mean, median, and mode are lies here. The most occurring point, this point, as you can see, the most the point that is having the maximum probability density value is our mean. And the same is our median, and same is our mode. Mode is generally the value that is occurring the most number of times. So our mode in normal distribution is our mean. And apart from that, maximum, our 99% of data lies in between three standard deviation from our mean, on the left hand side as well as on the right hand side. What is standard deviation? Standard deviation is a kind of measure of how spread your data is. So for now, just remember this thing, that more the value of standard deviation, more spread your data is. So if my sigma is present here, you can see if my sigma is large, this graph will be more spreaded across my mean. And if my sigma is low, the graph will be more kind of concentrated towards the mean, meaning that more values are present that are closer to the mean. You can see in that way. If sigma is large, it means that values are present away from the mean. So yeah, again, coming to normal distribution, as I said, 99% of data lies within three standard deviations. About 68% of the data lies between one standard deviation. You can see from here and here, 66% of the total data will be present in between those these two points. And in two standard deviation, there are 95% of the data that is present. And in three standard deviation, around 99.6% of the total data is present. The data that are away from these three standard deviation are known as outliers, or sometimes we treat them as outliers. But again, that outliers depends on the certain value. Sometimes there are, we also consider 2.5 sigma to be a threshold for outliers. But again, yeah, that will be for our future discussion in our statistics playlist. Currently, just remember that normal distribution example for the normal distributions are heights of people. If you know that my height of people, generally people are around a height of 5 feet 10 inches, and very less people are having a height above 6 foot or 6 feet or 6.2 inches. So those lies in this area, and very few people are going to have a height of, let us say, 4 feet or 3.5 feet. Those lies in left area. In between area, the most number of the people are going to have a certain height, that is, or let us say 5.5 inches to 5.10 inches. Those lies in this area. So height of people follows a normal distribution. Same lies for weight of people. Same applies for the errors in measurement. As you know that the error value of errors having large values is very less present in some measurements, and values corresponding to the small values is also present very less. A certain way for any experiment, there is a certain range in between the errors occurring will be high. And same applies for the IQ of people. IQ, as you know, IQ follows our normal distributions. There are only very less number of people that lies in this area having IQ score greater than 180. Generally, people have IQ score of 100 to 150. And the people lying before the 100 are, you can say, random people also have them present in the world. So, yeah, how to create an array, or how to create an array of numbers that is going to follow normal distributions. Again, the syntax is simple. Just need to use the random module of our NumPy library, and in that random module there is a method known as normal. So using that normal method, we can create an array that is going to follow a certain normal distribution. In that, we need to give input of our mean value, we need to give the input of standard deviation value, and the size, what size we want to create. So yeah, let us create an array. Let us name it as X, and that is going to be following our normal distribution. Okay, let us say that I want a mean of 10, and I want a standard deviation of 5, and I want 100 of these points, or maybe let us say 1000. I want 1000 these points. So this is my one distribution named X, and I also want to create another distribution that is going to have a same, let us take the same mean, but a different standard deviation. So you can get an idea that how dealing with the standard deviation goes place. So, okay, now I'm going to plot the distribution plots for both of these. X and Y, let us say. Here you can see the blue one is my X, because blue one is my X, you can see. Why? Because its standard deviation is less. Its standard deviation is 5 only. And the orange one is my Y, having a standard deviation of 10. So in that way, you can see that by varying the standard deviation, your spread of the data is varying. So you are getting a value up to -20 and 14 in our Y distribution, where our standard deviation is more. But in your standard deviation is 5, in that case only you are getting a value up to -5 to 20. So what will happen if I also vary the mean of my Y? Let us say I'm varying the mean from 10 to 5. What is happening that here you can see the peak of the both of the curves are lying at the 10, because our mean was 10, and as I said, in normal distribution, the value of mean is going to corresponding to mode, or the most occurring value in our distribution. So now I am replacing my mean as 5 in the orange one, and standard deviation, let us say, only 10 is there. And I'm also going to add the grids in the plot, so it will be easy to visualize the graph. So here you can see the mean of the orange distribution has been changed from 10 to 5, but the blue one is having a mean at 10. So in that way, you can see the, you can visualize that how by varying standard deviation and by varying mean, how your total data points are varying. So if I increase the value of my size of the distribution, you will see that this curve will become more of smoothness. Smoothness will be there in our curve. From 1,000, I have increased to 10,000. So you can see that the curves will smoothen itself. Here you can see the curve has been smooth in comparison to the before it was present. So now here I have made an array X and Y. Those are going to having a one dimension. If you are going to check the dimension of these arrays, it is going to return me one, because it is going to have a shape in one dimension only. I am only getting 10,000 arrays. But what happens in deep learning, you need to have an arrays that are going to have some kind of shape in two dimension, or you can say that are going to have some shape, let us say X and Y, X cross Y. So in that case, what we need to do, we just need to parcel, we just need to give the input of size as that shape. As here you can see, I have made an array X that is going to have a mean of 10 and standard deviation of 5, and its size is 4 cross 5. So it is going to, X is going to have a 4 rows and 5 columns. So when I'm going to write the X, it is going to return me an array that is having 4 rows and 5 columns, and that is having a mean of 10 and standard deviation of 5. So you can see the different values that are present. And here you can see the more of the values are present nearby 10 only, and very less values are present that are kind of out of away from 3 sigma. 3 sigma, you can say 25 and minus 15. So yeah, you can see there are none of the values that are larger than 20 or less than 0. So that is the scenario here. So this was the normal distribution. Now comes the standard normal distribution. Standard normal distributions is the nothing but the normal distribution that is going to have a mean as a 0 and standard deviation as 1. So how that will look, we will see. So first of all, let us create a normal distribution. So what is going to happen here? I'm just giving the input of size in my normal np.random.normal. In place of log and scale, I'm letting them as empty, and I'm only giving this size as input. So what happens that it automatically generate me a standard normal distribution. So, okay, I want 100 points that are going to follow standard normal distribution. Let us see the distribution plot of these points. So here you can see our mean is 0 here, and our standard deviation will be 1. Because you can see that after 3, 99% of the points are present in between 3 and minus 3. So we know that this is the standard deviation as 1. So this is one method for creating a standard normal distribution. Another method is by using random. This is np.random.normal. The other method is just by using random.random. For example, I'm giving an example. Here you can see I'm creating another array, say X, by using np.random.random, and just I need to give here the size of my distribution that I want, or you can say shape of the distribution. I have given here 100, so it means that I want 100 points that are going to follow a standard normal distribution. So what is the difference between this random and normal is that in normal you need to specify that, okay, my size is 100, because if you only give it 100, it is going to give me an mean of 100. Here you can see my mean is 100, because in normal, random.normal, there are three parameters: mean, standing as log, scale is my standard deviation, and size. So you need to specify this size here clearly, okay, that my size is 100 and it is a normal distribution, standard normal distribution. But in random, you don't need to specify the size, you don't need to write the size, just give one input that will be your size, and it will automatically generate the distribution. So when I'm going to see my distribution again of this snx.x, sns.displot of x, here you can see it is a standard normal distribution having a mean of 0 and standard deviation of 1. So this was my standard normal distribution. So, okay, let us create another array Y that is going to have 1,000 points. And if I'm going to plot this, as I said earlier, nothing will happen. Just my plot will become more smooth than before. Hey, this plot. So yeah, here I used rent and yeah. So yeah, this is rent. And in the previous video, we discussed about rent. So what happens that rent doesn't follow any distribution. It will not follow any distribution. And when I'm going to create a array by using rent function, what will happen? We will see that. Okay, let us say Z, and I'm going to create np.random.rent. And I am giving an input of, let us say, 1000. So what happens in rent is that it is going to give me a number between 0 to 1, and that doesn't follow any distribution. That is the difference between rent and random. Random will give me normal standard normal distribution, and rent will be give me just random numbers without following any distribution. And if you are going to plot these values, this plot, or we can say, let us see the histogram of this Z. Here you can see these are just random numbers without following any distribution. So that is the difference between rent and random. Now the next distribution is uniform distribution. So in normal distribution, we see that the probability is kind of varying in such a way that on the right hand side and the left hand side of the mean, the probability is decreasing. So your mean is going to have the maximum probability to be repeating in the distributions. So what happens in uniform distribution, that probability of every outcome is equally likely. Here you can see, if I want to create a uniform distribution between two points, let us say A and B, so probability of occurring every point will be equal. Every point will be going to have an equal probability, and that will be equal to 1 divided by B minus A. So you will get a rectangular shape curve of your, say, probability density function and your X. And examples are drawing a card from a card deck. You have a card set of, say, 54 cards. And if you are going to get, if you are going to draw a card from that card deck, the probability of coming one ace of spade is equal to the probability of coming of ace of hearts. So each card is going to have a same probability. So that is a uniform distribution. Other example is a rolling a dice. If you are rolling a dice, the probability of coming 6, 4, 3, every number is 1/6 only. So that is also a uniform distribution. So how to create a uniform distribution using random module of NumPy? Again, it is simple. Let us see. Just write np.random, and there is this method present in random known as uniform. So in that uniform, you just need to specify the higher point and the lower point. Let us say my lower point is 1, my higher point is 10, and I want 1000 values in between them. So it is going to create an array that is going to follow a uniform distribution. And if you are going to visualize it by using this plot, you can see that, okay, yeah, here the rectangular type of curve is coming. And if you visualize the histograms, you can see that, okay, every value is going to have a kind of equal probability for coming. If I'm going to visualize the histogram plot in place of this plot, it will be more helpful for us. Yeah, here you can see that probability of the count of every values in between 1 to 10 is equal. So it is a random, it is a uniform distribution because probability of every point is equal. As we also seen earlier, the choice function of random, by using that choice function also, you can also make a uniform distribution. Here is our example. I create an array, let us name it X, and I have used the choice function here. I have given a list between 1 to 10, and my probability of coming every point is 0.1 only, so that my probability is equally distributed between the elements of my list, and my size is 1000. My size is 10,000. And if I'm going to again plot the distribution histogram plot of this, you are going to see that, okay, the bars corresponding to each value is going to be having a equal value count. Here you can see for 10,000 size, each and every value is kind of coming nearby 1000 only. So yeah, we are going to have a uniform distribution. So this was for creating discrete values uniform distribution. Just give the probability values equally for every number present in your list. And if you want to create a continuous distribution, continuous values, then use np.random.uniform. So these two, the uniform distribution and normal distribution, are the most important distributions that we are going to use for generating random values. There are also certain different type of distributions, for example, binomial distribution and Poisson distribution. You can also create your array following the binomial distribution or say Poisson distribution by just using np.random. And after that, just name the distribution that I want. That okay, here I want a binomial distribution. And here in binomial distribution, you need to give two inputs. One is your total number of trials, and the second is your probability. Now what are these two things that we are going to discuss in our statistics playlist? Because these binomial and Poisson distribution are not that kind of important. Important distributions were uniform distribution and normal distribution that we already discussed. And as we said earlier, that this random number generation is very important because we are going to use it a lot in our deep learning or many more things also in our, when we are going to visualize the things in our Matplotlib or seaborn session, in that also we are going to use a lot number of random numbers. And also if you don't have any data and you want to perform some machine learning algorithm, you want to learn some machine learning algorithm, and you want to, that okay, I don't have data, but I want to learn it, how I want to see how it works, in that case also you can make your synthetic data by using these random number generation. So that's all for this session, guys. In the next video, we are going to end our NumPy session. We are going to discuss certain functions that are left in our NumPy, just general mathematical function that will be helpful. And after that, we are going to start the pandas. I hope you like the video. Thank you. Bye-bye. Take care.